forward for the camera, or is it off line?
Good afternoon. Today's the sixth Sunday of Easter. Tomorrow's Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day to all of our moms. The celebrant of this Mass is Father James O'Driscoll, and the Mass is being offered for the repose of the soul of Salvatore Sina.
Good afternoon. Why am I still muted? Our gathering song can be found at number 458 in the Green Book, 458. Alleluia, sing to Jesus, 458. Please stand.
This Mass is being celebrated for Salvatore Sina. Eternal rest grant for Salvatore, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him, with your saints forever, for you are merciful. And may perpetual light shine upon him. And may the souls of the faithful departed to the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. Proclaim a joyful sound and let it be heard. Proclaim to the ends of the earth the Lord has freed his people. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, a And the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are truly risen from the dead, our Passover sacrifice for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast not with the old leaven, the leaven of malice and evil, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are risen from the dead and will never die again. Death no longer has rule over you. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are risen from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
The glory to God in the highest can be found on the inner page of the cover page of the Green Book, or for a larger print at number 147. Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The readings begin in the back third of the book at number 913 for the sixth Sunday of Easter, A, 913.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip, when they heard it and saw the signs that he was doing. For unclean spirits, crying out in a loud voice, came out of many possessed people, and many paralyzed or crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. Now when the apostles in Jerusalem heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God, they sent them Peter and John, who went down and prayed for them, that they might receive the Holy Spirit, for it had not yet fallen upon any of them. They had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then they laid hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. to the glory of his name. Proclaim his glorious praise. Say to God, how tremendous are your deeds. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Let all on earth worship and sing praise to you. Sing praise to your name. Come and see the works of God, his tremendous deeds among the children of Adam. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. He has changed the sea into dry land. Through the river they passed on foot. Therefore, let us rejoice in him. He rules by his might forever.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, sanctify Christ as Lord in your hearts. Always be ready to give an explanation to anyone who asks you for a reason for your hope, but do it with gentleness and reverence, keeping your conscience clear so that when you are maligned, those who defame your good conduct in Christ may themselves be put to shame. For it is better to suffer for good, doing good, if that be the will of God, than for doing evil. For Christ also suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you. Jesus
said to his disciples, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you always, the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot accept, because it neither knows nor sees him. But you know him, because he remains with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me, because I live and you will live. On that day, you will realize that I am in my Father, and you are in me, and I in you. Whoever has my commandments and observes them is the one who loves me. And whoever loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and reveal myself to him. The Gospel of the Lord. I remember my confirmation, I think it was Bishop Minahan. It was a long time ago, I'm not going to tell you when. And in St. Catherine's in Somerville. And I was very excited about this, about receiving this special gift of the Holy Spirit. Sister Jamela had instructed us, we had special instruction on our confirmation. And we were told that we were to be soldiers of Christ. And the custom there then was a little tap on the cheek to remind you that you're going to have opposition. But we reminded that God would be with us in everything. We were to be soldiers of the faith, which meant we had to know our faith well enough to defend it. And little did I know how much that would be needed, how much our society had turned against the teachings of the church, the way of life, which was just considered normal at that time. And St. Peter reminds the people, always be ready to give an explanation to anyone who asks you for a reason for your hope. That is in Jesus Christ. But, he said, do it with gentleness and reverence, because the temptation is to give back what they give to us, to be nasty back, but that is not helpful. Rather, to do it with firmness, but gentleness and detachment, and reverence for the humanity of the other people, but above all, reverence for our faith, reverence for our Lord Jesus Christ. As we are told, sanctify Christ as Lord in your hearts. Honor him as such and live in his holiness. And when Philip had gone and evangelized people in Samaria, people who were not Jewish, the apostles came up, and Peter and John, and went down and prayed for these people, and they found out that, prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Spirit through the laying on of hands, which is, we would see this as the sacrament of confirmation. For it had not fallen upon any of them. They received the Holy Spirit in baptism, being baptized in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, even though it says in the name of the Lord Jesus, which means in the authority of the Lord Jesus. So they did lay hands on them, which was the apostolic sign of confirmation. Chrismation, being anointed with chrism, came later. They laid hands on them and they received the Holy Spirit in a special way. Well, we who are confirmed have received the Holy Spirit in a very special way, in this sacramental presentation of God the Holy Spirit to us. And as I said, I was very excited about my confirmation. And I took it seriously. And my mother said, my father usually cut our hair, the boys here anyway. Put it mildly, he was not trained for that. And so my mother said, well, you should go to the barber. So I went to the barber. There was a new barber who, it turned out, spoke no English. So I said, just a little. He shaved my head. And I was very sensitive to humiliation at that time, and I was humiliated. It looked more like I was being initiated in a Buddhist monastery that I was being confirmed. But we need to release the Holy Spirit. We keep all sorts of things around us so that we can fit in. But if we're living in Christ, we're never going to fit into our culture the way it's gone. In our the the social norms which keep changing, becoming ever more and more bizarre and ever more violent. And so we need to live in this, live in the power of the Holy Spirit. And yes, we'll suffer. But St. Peter reminds us it's better to suffer for doing good than for doing evil. For Christ also suffered for sins once. And so we're being people who are experiencing the power of Jesus' saving death and resurrection and unite ourselves to his saving death and resurrection when we go through all these things. So we're told, put to death in the flesh. This is Jesus. He was brought to life in the Spirit. That Spirit with a capital S, the Holy Spirit. He was bodily raised, and we too will be raised. And he who ascended into heaven, this Thursday will be celebrating the feast of the ascension of Jesus and his intercession for us as our great high priest and all-sufficient sacrifice before the Father and the power of the Holy Spirit. But he tells us, Jesus, he will give you, the Father will give you another advocate to be with you always. Jesus is an advocate, the Parakletos, or Parakletos, which has many meanings, coach, counselor, comforter, defense attorney, advocate, spokesman, for many things. But we're told he's the Spirit of truth for us and will be with us, whom the world cannot accept. The truth, the moral truth, the theological truth, God bless you, and God bless everybody. And the world rejects that. But we are to profess that and live the truths of the Lord, no matter how spurned they may be by the world, no matter how difficult they may be in the struggle to live a full life, to truly live authentically. And Jesus says, don't worry that you'll be left alone. The Spirit of truth will be with you. And he says, I will not leave you orphans. I'm not abandoning you. Imagine how the apostles felt at his ascension. He had just come back from the dead, and now he was leaving. But he says, I'm not really leaving you. I'm not leaving you orphans. I will come to you. And actually, we're closer to Jesus now, if we're open to that power of the Holy Spirit, than the apostles were before the death and resurrection of Christ, and before that great outpouring on Pentecost. So our confirmation should be our own personal Pentecost, and we should release the Spirit in our lives by the power of God's grace. For Christ is with us. He is always with us. And let us stand and proclaim our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed, which can be found on the front cover of the green book, the inner cover, or if allowed, you're printed number 148. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. As we prepare for a greater outpouring of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost, let us pray for this, a deeper gift of the Holy Spirit, and pray for the whole world, especially those who are suffering in body, mind, or spirit.
Father, your Son, Jesus Christ, risen from the dead, is the Lord of life. Send into our hearts your Holy Spirit, that we may joyfully acknowledge Jesus to the whole world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father, bless all our mothers and those who have the role of mother, both living and those you have called home. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dear Father, as we celebrate Christ's resurrection, bless our First Communion children on this Mother's Day, especially as they crown our Blessed Mother Mary. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dear Father, stop the war in Ukraine. Encourage and protect its noble people through the intercession of our Mother, the Queen of the Holy Rosary. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, Easter tells us that every human being is of immortal value in your eyes. Protect the unborn, the elderly, those facing terror, disease, or disaster, and protect our military wherever they serve. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, heal the sick, in particular those whose names are in our Book of Prayer Intentions, and especially Teresa Henriksen, Helen Ambrose, Eric Wolf, Baby David Ortiz, Sherry MacDougall, Irene Dalala, Lee Weber, David Whitman, Stephen Beaton, T. Lai, Mike McGrath, Mark Davis, Dennis DiGiusto. Lift their spirits, heal them, and give them peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, Christ is the salvation of all who die in him. Grant eternal rest to Patricia Berkeley, Harold Dunn, Diane Hertigan, Aaron Moriarty Gutnecht, Claire Garvey, for whom there will be a funeral mass on Tuesday at 9 a.m., for Barbara Wood, for whom there will be a funeral mass on Friday at 9 a.m., and for Teresa Squires, for whom there will be a pro-burial mass on Saturday at 9 a.m., and for Salvatore Sina, for whom this mass is being offered, and to all our faithful departed, as well as those in our military who have died serving our country. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And on May 13th, we commemorate the apparitions in Portugal in 1917 of Our Lady to the three shepherd children there with a message, the gospel message of repentance, prayer, and living according to the faith, living according to faith. And hope and love. And tomorrow would be commemorated on May 14th, although it's a Sunday, so this Sunday takes precedence, St. Matthias the Apostle, who was the one who took the place of Judas, who was chosen by lot, and who was later martyred. O God, who assigned St. Matthias a place in the College of Apostles, grant us, through his intercession, that rejoicing at how your love has been allotted to us, we may merit to be numbered among the elect through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. And let's together pray the Hail Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Our song for the preparation of the gifts can be found in the Green Book at number 481. Hail Mary, Gentle Woman, number 481.
The Lord is with you.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And
with your spirit. Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a new universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Eucharistic Prayer 1. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants. Especially the family of Salvatore Cina and the family of Patricia Berkeley. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating that most sacred day on which your only begotten Son, our Lord, placed at the right hand of your glory our weak human nature, which he had united to himself, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and martyrs, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers at all things, we may be defended by your protecting help through Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen through Christ our Lord. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, save from all the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them as one who were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants, especially Salvatore Cina, who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace through Christ our Lord. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord. Amen. Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The communion antiphon. If you love me, keep my commandments, says the Lord, and I will ask the Father, and he will send you another, the Paraclete, to abide with you forever. Alleluia.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Our song for communion can be found in the Spirit Song Book at number 189, One Sacrifice of Christ, number 189.
Christ is risen as he said, and will come to
Body of Christ. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food through Christ our Lord. Amen. And please be seated for a few moments, Father. Vicky is going to say something to us.
Good afternoon. You know I'm here to cause you trouble. So over all these years, we've made fun of and had joy about and always succeeded in supporting the parish. And I think I need to tell you that I need you to look at if you're giving or not to the Grand Annual. At this point last year, we had gathered $85,440. At this point, or rather, that's what we've gathered this year, 85,000. Last year at this point, we had 96, almost 97,000. There are 7 weeks left between now and the end of the fiscal year on June 30th. What we really need is about $74,000, $75,000, so $10,000 every month. Every time I get up here at this point, everybody jokes and laughs, and I do too, because I'm like a mother hen, maybe like a mother on Mother's Day, wondering if we'll be okay. So I need you to be consistent. If you haven't given, I need you to give. And if it's 200, you can give, fine. If it's 20, then that's fine too. A lot of you, as I'm looking at you, are in fixed incomes. You do the best you can. If we don't reach it, we don't reach it. It's about 60% of our income for our, the expenses of the parish. So I'm coming to you asking you to keep in mind that the parish needs financial support, and we've regularly done that. Also, I think you know, my mother had a Gaelic word for it, Craignuel, that I don't spend what we don't have, that we were blessed when we renovated the building and put in the elevator and did over the parking lot because we were able to sell property, we were able to pay it all off and put money in savings. We do have savings, and it's a good amount. And we also have invested money with the Archdiocese. So we're not in trouble, and we won't be in trouble. And it could happen, without any speculation, that when I'm gone, it may be the wisdom of yourselves and the guy following me to do different things and take some of that savings and spend it in other ways. I've seen that happen in parishes, and often it was a wise move. But Hickey's Craignuel, he doesn't spend money. We give money, by the way. Along with St. Vincent, we take care of a number of people, and it's always happening. And it happens in different ways, and you are the people doing it. You don't even know it's happening. So I need you to help. If you haven't given, please do. And of course, I'm looking at a few of you. You're worth a few million. I know you are. So if you have given already, give some more. And you can yell and scream about Hickey on the way home. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
And we have some other announcements. For especially prayers for mothers, both those who are spiritual mothers as well as physical mothers, and all who fulfill the role of mother in our community and in our lives. May is the month of our Mother Mary. Our First Communion children will crown her statue on Mother's Day tomorrow, May 14th at the 10 a.m. Mass. This week we shall celebrate the ascension of our Lord into heaven. It's a holy day of obligation. Masses will be Wednesday at 4 p.m. and on Thursday at 9 a.m. and 7 p.m. A bottle and can drive by the Rotary Club in support of Rockland High School's National Honor Society will be next Saturday here in our parking lot from 9 a.m. until 1 p.m. Check the bulletin. Only clean containers can be accepted. My Brother's Keeper will sponsor a family walk on June 10th. Check the bulletin. We would like to start a rosary prayer group at South Shore Nursing Home. If you are interested, please check the bulletin. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Our recessional is in the Green Book at number 703. Let there be peace on earth, number 703.